Hi, I'm Norman Wildberger, and today we're going to have a look at some applications of rational trigonometry to surveying. The first problem we'll consider is the height of a mountain. There's the mountain. We'd like to know how high it is. We're here and here. We take two spread measurements, S1 and S2. We assume that these are these two values here. And we also know this distance here is 1300, so the corresponding quadrants is 1300 squared. We need to solve this triangle here, A1, A2, A3. We know two spreads. The third spread, S3, is given by the triple spread formula. Now, I'm going to rewrite that triple spread formula in a new way that you haven't seen before. Here's the new way. This is exactly equivalent to the previous one, except we've rewritten it so that the S3 only appears in one place. Quite a beautiful derivation to go from here to here, and I suggest it to you as an exercise. The advantage of this form is that the S3 only appears here, so it's a quadratic equation ready to solve. We plug these two values of S1 and S2 into here, and the equation becomes S3 minus 0.390 squared equals 0.131. It's a quadratic equation which has two solutions. Now we have to stop for a minute and say, well, what are the two solutions? Well, one of them is the one that we're interested in. That's this one here. The other one corresponds to the situation where this line is making a same spread, but over here. Okay? So in other words, the triangle is actually this one right here. There'll be a different spread, S3, there. All right, we'll take that value of S3 there, and now we use the spread law to find Q1. Q1 equals Q3 over S3, times S1. We work that out. We get that quantity, 1098 times 10 to the fourth. And now once we've got this Q1, and we know that spread S2, then H is equal to S2 times Q1. So remember the definition of a spread. The spread there is H over Q1. So H equals S2 Q1, which is 360 times 10 to the fourth. So to get the height, little h, we just take the square root, and that's 1900. So we've solved for the height of the mountain. Our second surveying problem is actually probably the first max-min problem in history. It goes back to a 1500 mathematician called Regiomontanus. His problem was the following. We've got a window right here. We know how high the window is off the ground. It's the building there, it's the window. We're interested in where that point A should be in order to maximize the spread subtended by the window. In other words, to maximize how big that window looks from the point A. All right, so there's a few relations with the quantities that I've described. That quadrant's P plus that quadrant's Q1 equals that quadrant's R by Pythagoras' theorem. So R equals P plus Q1. The spread S2, which is the spread between that line and that line, that spread S2 is the same as that spread there. That's by definition Q2 over this quadrants. What is this quadrants? By Pythagoras, it's P plus Q2. So that spread S2 is Q2 over P plus Q2. Now let's have a look at this triangle here. S over Q, by the spread law, is this spread divided by R. What is this spread? Well, if that's S2, that's a right triangle, so that's got to be 1 minus S2. So S over Q equals 1 minus S2 divided by R. And now we rewrite this, we take the Q up to the other side. So we get S equals Q times. Now, 1 minus S2, what's that? Well, here's S2, so 1 minus S2 will be P over P plus Q2. So there's P over P plus Q2, that's the 1 minus S2. And the R in the denominator, it's equal to P plus Q1, there's the P plus Q1. That's now an expression for S, which depends there on P. And to make it a little bit simpler, I divide by this common P, so we divide the P there, and then we write out that denominator and divide by P. We get Q1 plus Q2 plus two terms involving P. This one and this one. Our problem is to choose P in order to maximize this quantity. Well, the Q's are all constant, so it really is the same as asking which value of P minimizes this quantity, because this quantity is in the denominator. Now, let's have a look at these two terms. If we multiply P and Q1, Q2 over P, we get something that's constant, independent of P. So our problem is to maximize the sum of two things if the product of those two things is a known constant. Well, it's a kind of a standard algebraic fact that in such a situation, you want to minimize the sum by choosing these two quantities to be the same. Okay? So the sum is minimized when P equals Q1, Q2 over P, right here. Well, that means that P squared equals Q1, Q2, or P is the square root of Q1, Q2, the geometric mean between Q1 and Q2. That's a beautiful result, and it has a geometrical interpretation too, which I'll leave to you as an exercise. Let's go back up to this picture. It turns out that if you look at the circle, there's a unique circle that goes through these two points and is tangent to our baseline. So a circle tangent to the baseline going through these two points. And I'll leave it to you as an exercise to show you that that circle there is exactly the one which touches this line at the required point. Have a look at the previous video on geometry of circles and the equal products theorem to get a hint of how to solve that. Our last situation concerns a box, a rectangular box. A1, A2, A3 is a base triangle, and it's a right triangle because it's part of that base. Quadrants Q2, quadrants Q1, and the height of the box is H. Now what we're interested in is the diagonals across these two faces. That diagonal making a spread of R1, and that diagonal there making a spread of R2. And these two diagonals, they meet at the point B, they make some spread S. I'm going to show you how to find a beautiful relationship between S, R1, and R2 by analyzing the base triangle and using the cross law. So, first of all, the quadrants between A1 and A2 is by Pythagoras' theorem Q1 plus Q2, because that's a right triangle. The quadrants between A1 and B is Q2 plus H. Q2 plus H, it's also Pythagoras' theorem. The quadrants between A2 and B is Q1 plus H. Again, Pythagoras' theorem. Now, in this triangle, A1, A2, B, we use the cross law. Here are the three quantities. Q1 plus H, plus Q2 plus H, minus Q1 plus Q2, all squared, equals 4 times this quantity, times this quantity, times 1 minus S. Now, this cross law simplifies. The left-hand side just becomes 2 times H, all squared. So we isolate 1 minus S, and it becomes, the 4 is canceled, we get H squared on the top, and on the bottom, these two terms. We write that like this, H over Q1 plus H, H over Q2 plus H. And these two ratios, what are they? Well, H over Q1 plus H, that's the one there, that's R2. And H over Q2 plus H, H over Q2 plus H, that's R1. So the answer, 1 minus S equals R1 times R2. Independent of the quadrants Q1, Q2, and H. This is a very beautiful result. It, in fact, is very close to being the fundamental formula for projective trigonometry or spherical trigonometry. Something I'll show you in some later time. The next video, we're going to go back to Descartes and establish Cartesian equations and the Cartesian framework and investigate how rational trigonometry looks like using coordinates. I hope you'll join me. I'm Norm Wildberger. Thanks for listening.